Considering RB Leipzig only got funded in 2009, they are one of the most formidable teams you can come across in the entire Bundesliga league. They are yet to win any trophies, but 7 years after they were founded, they managed to get themselves into the Bundesliga. By the end of today's video, we're going to be making them European champions for the first time. The support you guys have shown me on this series has been nothing short of amazing. Thank you so much for the continued support. Let me know down below who you want me to rebuild next. Over 70% of you guys are still not subscribed, so if you are watching and you aren't subscribed yet, be sure to leave a like on the video if you do go on to enjoy it, and hit that subscribe button. It really does help with the YouTube algorithm. And if you haven't seen one of my rebuild videos before, here are the rules. The main objective of this video is to win the Champions League. I can make any transfers that I want whilst keeping it as realistic as possible. All games have to be simulated, but the Champions League final has to be played. We begin season one with a total of £50.48 million to spend. RB Leipzig are one of the better teams that we have rebuilt in quite some time. This team has got a lot of potential quite early on, to be honest. Their team has got a lot of young talent, got Olmo and Nkunku. We all know how good Nkunku turns out to be. Campbell, Sabitzer, Mukaleli, Klosterman, Upamecano, Galashi, Konate. It's still going to be tricky because we have got Bayern Munich and Borussia Dortmund to compete with in the Bundesliga. But realistically speaking, all we have to do is grow these guys, get them into the starting 11, get them playing decent football, get them into a formation where they're comfortable, and we should be on the right way to getting the Champions League. In my opinion, we've just made one of the best signings long-term we could have possibly made for RB Leipzig. We have bought the Jamaican Leon Bailey, 22 years of age, 81 rated. He is absolutely rapid. He cost us £47 million to rob away from Bayer Leverkusen. I could not be happier with this signing. That does conclude season one's first transfer window. The only signing we have made is bringing in Bailey from Bayer Leverkusen. Other than that, we have made a couple of changes. We've made some position changes, and Kunku's now on the left wing. Angelino will shortly become a left back. Mukaleli is a right back now, not a right wing back. I don't think that we're going to win it for the first couple of seasons. Season three is where we may potentially have a shot. Season one and two are all about growth because the team is very young, but they've got a lot of potential to go with it. But I believe in this season we do have Champions League, so let's go take a look at our group stage. Yeah, we're going out in the group stage. Oh my God, we're up against Paris Saint-Germain, Manchester United and Başakşehir. Yeah, I can never pronounce that name right. But boys, what is that, man? Come on. We ain't got a chance in hell in Group H. We really have been shafted here. This might be the first time we go out in the group stage. But it's United and PSG, man. There's only so much we can do against them. Nevertheless, let's see how we do. Let's go to the midway point of Season 1. Oh, no. It's happened. It's finally happened, guys. It's actually finally happened. We have been knocked out of the Champions League in only the group stage. But to be fair, though, if you look at the group stage that we had, it was the group of death, man. We had PSG to contend with, Manchester United to contend with. We were never going to top them with RB Leipzig in the first season. In other news, we are fourth in the Bundesliga. That's not too bad, I suppose, to be honest. Borussia Dortmund and Bayern Munich are the top two, of course. Followed by Frankfurt, then ourselves, then Hoffenheim, then Borussia Mönchengladbach, and Leverkusen, then Augsburg. Crashed out to the DFB Pokal in round three, losing 2-1 at home against Bayern Munich. I mean, it was to be expected, to be honest. I mean, we're never going to get success in the first season. My only issue is we may actually get the sack. We've got to pull off something big in order to maintain our job as manager of RB Leipzig in the second half of the season if we want to stay. I absolutely despise release clauses. We've been shafted here, guys. Konate has been bought for £50.3 million by AC Milan. I'm gutted, man. I like Konate as well. This is why I literally never put release clauses in contracts, because it will always come back to bite you in the backside. Nevertheless, though, we do have more money to play with, I suppose. We bought Fernandinho from Manchester City for £10 million. He's 84 rated and 35 years of age. He is Brazilian as well, which is one of the objectives. I'm going to be totally honest with you guys. There's two reasons that I bought Fernandinho. The first one, squad depth. There's never too much squad depth in the midfield role. And secondly, he is one of our objectives. We've got to buy players from South America just to get our manager score up, because I really don't want to get sacked. So the next couple of signings will be from South America. And finishing off that manager objective, we have signed Lucas Leiva, 34 years of age, 82 rated. He's not going to be getting into the starting 11. If he plays, it'll be from the subs bench, to be honest. But it is always good to have that squad depth. And that is the end of Season 2's first transfer window. This is the team that we're rocking with. But to be honest, they've really shot up. Mukaleli, Upamecano, Klosterman, Angelino has, Lima has, Sabitz has, and Kunku is flying up as a left winger. I can't believe how quick he's going up. He's only 23 as well. 23 years of age and 85 rated. The guy's a baller as well. I might swap Paulson with Sorloth because Paulson's high rated. But other than that, guys, this team's looking really good. I believe we are in the Europa League because we finished third in the group stage. So let's go over to that fixture. You're up against Alaves in the round 32 time. I'm pretty sure it's Deportivo Alaves, but I don't want to say that just in case I'm wrong. But nevertheless, we are rocking with this team going into each fixture now. I've replaced our other striker with Paulson purely because he's high rated, so it'll do better. I'm not going to lie to you. I mean, we should beat these guys. Come on, let's just take an away advantage. Come on, RB Leipzig. Let's do that. Yeah, 3-0 sorted. We are into the round of 16. I don't care about the second leg. If we somehow go out of this tie, we do not deserve to carry on this career mode episode. We have the three away goals, guys. We should absolutely annihilate these guys. Now, let's do it. 3, 2, 1. Can we get a win? Can we book our place in the round of 16? Easy peasy. 6-1 on aggregate. We're into the round of 16. We are up against Club Bruges in the round of 16. We are away from home in the first game. Let's hope that we can just replicate our performance against Alaves and absolutely smash them. They got mini lane goal after all, so we should be all right. Let's hope that we can get a decent away goal. Oh my God, we've done it again. 3-0. They didn't even have a shot, never mind a shot on target. Guys, we battered them onto the second leg. Once again, guys, we find ourselves 3-0 up. We're 3 away goals going into the second leg of the tie. Club Bruges have an Everest to climb in order to gain entry into the quarterfinals of the Europa Cup. With that being said, let's see if RB Leipzig have the strength to beat Club Bruges. Yeah, we do it. We've absolutely annihilated them. They didn't even have a shot throughout the entire tie. It was an absolute dominance from us from the start to the finish. Onto the quarters we go. We are against Stavrenay in the quarters of the Europa League. We've got some really good players, to be honest. They've got Nzonzi. They've got Camavinga, who is an absolute baller. They've got Jeremy Doku. They've got Tate. They've got Terrier. They've got a half-decent team, to be honest. But I believe we overpower them massively. Let's see if I'm right. Can we get the home advantage? Can we do... Oh, okay. So it's 2-1. It's 2-1. It's 2-1. That's not too bad. We've got the advantage still. But in the away fixtures, we do tend to do a lot better. So with that being said, let's go straight to the second leg. We are 2-1 up on aggregate going into this second leg tie, but they do have an away goal, which does worry me a little bit. But I do believe that we are better away from home. So I'm hoping that we can pull off a victory here. If we get a victory, it's done. Oh my God. 5-0. 5-0. And Kunku, Angelino. And Kunku's having the season of his life this season. I'm so happy I put him on the left wing. Oh my God. 5-0. Oh my, wow. Okay, onto the semis we go. Villarreal are our next challenge. I believe that they do have quite a good team. They've got Coquelin. They've got that left back whose name I can never pronounce. Asensio in goal. Bamba on the left. Parejo in the centre mid position with Coquelin. Belotti, Alcacer, Penna, Chukwueze. Yeah, that's a decent team. That is a decent team. But I do believe that we have got a better team. So let's put this to the test. Can we get a decent head start going into... Ooh, okay, it's a 2-2 draw. It is a 2-2 draw. It is a 2-2 draw. Guys, it's not bad. It's not bad, I'm not going to lie to you. But when we go to this second leg fixture, we need to batter them. We need to win. Guys, it is all to play for in this second leg. I'd love it if we could convincingly get to the final, but it's never that simple. Villarreal pose a very big threat, but nevertheless, it is RB Leipzig against Villarreal. I am ready. You're ready. Let's do this. Can we book our place in the final of the Europa League? I believe that we go through on the away goal system. I'm hoping so anyway. Let me just double check this. We are up against Bayer Leverkusen in the Europa League final. An all-German final in the Europa League. Guys, it's going to be quite tight, this is. Their team's actually pretty goddamn good as well. Hideki, Tapsoba, Palacios, Demirbe, Schick, Antonio, Depay, Tor. Guys, their team is actually pretty good, but I do believe that ours is better. It's got to be, surely. But nevertheless, can we win the Europa League? Come on. It would be so good if we could win the Europa League in the first season. Oh, come on. How did we lose, man? Oh, that's gutting. I thought for sure we'd have had it, but it is what it is. We lose in the final of the Europa League. I mean, it's disappointing, and Kunku did get sent off in the 70th minute. That didn't probably help matters, and Memphis Depay did win it for them in the 85th minute, so that probably had a direct link to Bayer Leverkusen winning. But we win some, we lose some, I suppose. But with that being said, let's see how we did elsewhere in Season 1. The good news is next year we are in the Champions League again. We have secured our spot by finishing third in the Bundesliga. Hopefully this time we won't get matched up in the group of death and we may actually make it out of the group stage this time. Frankfurt went on to beat Dortmund 2-1 in the DFB Pokal. That's pretty surprising, to be fair. Good on Frankfurt. And in the Champions League, PSG went on to beat Liverpool 2-0 in the final. That does make it a little bit easier on my conscience. No, we crashed out in the same group stage of the winners, so that is a little bit easier to take now. Guys, sticking on Nkunku on the left wing was probably the best decision I could have made. He's gone up 86 rated, 23 years of age, top goal scorer and top assister by the looks of it. Yes, he's top goal scorer and top assister. 30 goals and 10 assists. Guys, what a season he had. Leon Bailey had a pretty decent debut season as well. 83 rated, going up by 2. Scoring 17, assisting 8. Marcel Sabitzer going up to 85 rated, scoring 15, assisting 9. Poulsen getting 10 himself, assisting 2. Danny Olmo going up to 83 rated, scoring 4, assisting 7. Dominic, I'm not even going to try to pronounce his second name, went up 4 this year. Guys, I'm torn whether to put Olmo in the starting 11 or this guy. Oh God, it's got to be this guy, surely, because he's younger. All I know is that in season 2, a lot of things are going to change, and we genuinely do actually have a chance of winning the Champions League if we make the correct signings. With that being said, on to season 2. Season 2 sees us having a dramatic increase in our money to spend. We've been given £158.41 million. Pretty obvious where we need to improve. We need another striker without a shadow of a doubt. Poulsen's alright, but we need someone who is elite quality. I want to stick with this guy for this season. He's 20 years of age. He went up 3 last season, or 4, I'm not too sure. Look who's made his return back to RB Leipzig. Timo Werner the Bernard. 25 years of age and 85 rated. He is absolutely amazing. He cost us £81.2 million to steal back from Chelsea. That is the end of season 2's first transfer window. I cannot explain how much more confidence I am going into the Champions League this year with this team. I really want this guy to improve. I've seen him loads in career mode and he is always in the top teams by the end of it when I'm finished. So I'm guessing that he does go up quite a lot. So I do want to give him a chance, but the rest of the team looks absolutely insane and it gives me great confidence going into the Champions League. I can't even lie to you. With that being said, let's see if we've got the group of death again. This time we've got a little bit of an easier group. We've got our old friends Juve, Spartak Moscow and BSC Young Boys. We should manage to get through this group stage and get through to the round of 16 this time, but who knows what can happen, eh? Let's go to the midway point of the season and see how we got on. So we went on to top our group. We got 15 points out of a possible 18 and Juve were closely behind us with 13. So it is us and Juventus going through to the round of 16. The question is, who is our opponent? This is a new one. We're against Inter Milan. Okay, that's a fresh opponent for a change. I like that a lot. Okay, Inter Milan versus RB Leipzig, round of 16. In the Bundesliga, we're currently sitting pretty at fifth in the league. Frankfurt are absolutely doing bits at the minute. Top of the table, 2 points clear of Dortmund, 3 points clear of Bayern Munich. Guys, what is up with Frankfurt? We're in the quarterfinals of the DFB Pokal. We are playing away from home against Bayern Leverkusen. We have stolen Juve's number one keeper away from them for £53.9 million. Polish keeper is 31 years of age and 87 rated. We have bought him because Galashi is currently injured and our next best keeper is about 70 rated. And going into the Champions League with a 70 rated keeper is not a great idea at all. So we have brought in Szczesny. And we have come to the end of the second transfer window in season. Two, we have a huge second half of the season ahead of us. We are in the round of 16 in the Champions League against Inter Milan. This is the team that we have got. They are looking insane, if I'm being totally honest with you guys. I just wish this guy would go up a bit more for quicker. I'm a little bit impatient with him, granted, but I want him to go up a little bit more, a little bit quicker. But nonetheless, we go into the round of 16 tie against Inter Milan looking very strong. Let's get to it. So here we are, the round of 16. We are away in the first leg of this tie. Their team looks absolutely ridiculous. That back three is ridiculous. Varane, Kimpembe and Schürrle. Brozovic, Barella, Christensen, Hakimi, Lamar, Lukaku, Moreno and Danovic. We have definitely got our work cut out for us against Inter Milan. But the question is, can we make a dent to them in this away leg? Can we make anything? Oh my God, we've got a one goal advantage, away goal as well, going into the second leg of this tie. I genuinely thought Inter Milan were going to run us over then. But Nkunku, as per usual, bails us out. Let's go to the second leg. Inter Milan do have the work cut out for them. We can't really afford to concede, man, because, like, Inter Milan, their firepower is ridiculous. I'm hoping that because we're at home, we've got that home advantage, we play a bit better. But for some reason, we tend to have better luck when we're away from home. But nevertheless, can we knock out Italian giants Inter Milan? We've done it as well. We knocked them out 2-1 in the round of 16. We are through to the quarterfinals. The question is, who is our opponent? Just City are our quarterfinal opponents. We do have one massive player out as well. Mukaleli is out. So Hendricks has taken a spot at the right back position. Guys, that front three that Manchester City have got is just unbelievable. Sterling, Haaland and Mahrez. Guys, I'm not going to lie to you. If we can somehow make it out of the quarterfinals and get into the semi-finals, it is scripted for us. Because there's no way we should be beating this Manchester City team. We are away from home. We are good away from home, though. Oh my God, we got a draw. Guys, we could actually do this. We could actually do this. If they can only manage a draw at home, away from home, they may not play as well. But we somehow managed to get a draw at Man City with that team. Come on! We are fielding our best team against Manchester City. But guys, their team, oh my God, the squad depth that they have got is just mental. I got Foden, didn't even play Foden in the last game either. Phil Foden joins Manchester City's team. Wijndal comes in at left back instead of Mendy. Yeah, this is going to be tough, man. Can we somehow knock out the English giants in the quarterfinals? Can we do it? We've actually done it. We've actually done it as well. Oh my God, we've done it. Boys, we got the away goal, so we are through to the semi-finals. We've just knocked out Manchester City. No matter what, Manchester City just can't seem to win the Champions League, can they? Okay, we are up against Bayern goddamn Munich in the semi-finals. We're up against the German giants themselves. Their team is just goddamn ridiculous. I think that's Lucas Hernandez at left back, not Theo. There's Lenglet, Denaya actually isn't that good, to be honest. Neuer, Kimmich, Tolisso, Goretzka, Koeman, Muller has got to be getting on at this point. Gnabry, Lewandowski. It's a very, very good team. But I do believe we've actually done the double over them this year. So, I mean, who knows? Can we do the triple over them? Ah, no, they win 2-1. They win 2-1. That does mean we've got a mountain to climb in the second leg of this fixture. Kimmich and Tolisso punishing us. Werner misses a penalty in the 6th minute. But Werner does bag one in the 1st minute. So, it is what it is, I suppose. We do have a lot of work to do in the second leg, though. Let's see what we can do. Guys, to say that we've got a mountain to climb in this game is an understatement, to say the least. We're up against Bayern Munich, the German giants themselves. We're down 2-1 on aggregate, and those two goals are away goals. Yeah, we've got a tough challenge ahead of us. But nevertheless, guys, we have got an exceptionally good team to come up against Bayern Munich with. The thing is, though, even if we don't win and we go out in the semi-finals, we're in Season 2. I genuinely didn't think we were going to get this far in Season 2, never mind Season 3 or 4. So, with that being said, let's see what we can do. If we can somehow pit by into the post and beat them. Oh my God. Oh my God, we've actually done it. We've actually just done it. We're in the final of Season 2 with RB Leipzig. Nkunku getting one and Werner getting the rest. Guys, oh my God, I'm actually speechless. I can't believe we've done it. In 2009, this club was founded. In 2022, could this club get their first European Championship? Let's see who our opponent is, who stands in the way of that happening. Jesus Christ, we have not had it easy in this Champions League, have we? We are up against Barcelona in the final. The Spanish giants themselves. We're up against Messi. We're up against Griezmann. We're up against a very, very good team. But before we get into the final, let's take a look at how we've done this season. Guys, we won the Bundesliga this season. We won by 4 points as well. Oh my God. Guys, we've absolutely smashed it this season. Jesus, I did not expect that at all. So even if we don't win the Champions League, we can safely say that we've got a spot in the Champions League next year and we have won the Bundesliga this year. Come on. We unfortunately did not win the DFB Pokal, though Bayern Munich did beat us in the final 2-1. And Lazio did end up beating AC Milan 2-0 in the Europa League final. I knew bringing Timo Werner back this year would do us justice. Look at him. He's scored 31 goals. He hasn't assisted anybody. He's a striker at the end of the day, and he's gone up to 87 rated. And Nkunku is just unbelievable. Honest to God, I put him at left wing just on the off chance that he'd do well, and he's turned out to be insane on the left-hand side of the field. 89 rated he is this season, 18 goals and 10 assists. Marcel, 87 rated, 16 goals, 10 assists. Conrad Laime, 8 goals, 7 assists. Leon Bailey, 3 overall increase, 6 goals, 9 assists. Guys, the boys have done absolutely amazing this season, and the only way that they can make it any better is if we beat Barcelona in the final. Okay, so no Messi to deal with, but they have got Jesus, Griezmann, Martial. De Jong is going to be a nightmare to deal with. Dembele, I'm assuming that's Moussa Dembele, but I'm not sure. They've got Pjanic, Pedri. Pedri's a don, we all know that. Roman Nogli, Skriniar, Pique, he's got to be getting on a bit now as well. And Ter Stegen. They're playing 3-1-4-2, which is pretty risky, I'm not going to lie. We're going to destroy them on the wings with our pace. And Kunku, Werner and Bailey coming at you. No, mate, you ain't got a chance against that pace. But nevertheless, we are up against Barcelona in the Champions League final. Let's see what we can do. Got the ball with Bailey. Can we find Werner? Oh, what a bloody block that is. What a, oh my God. What a ball. Can we get Werner inside? Please. Oh my God. What a goal. Pit that one out your net, Ter Stegen. Come on, the boys. Werner. He makes it 1-0 in the Champions League final. Oh, what? Let's just take a look at this. We get the ball. He has, I can't remember his name. He has such a good touch there. And Werner is never missing from that position. We make it 1-0 to us in the Champions League final against Barcelona. Come on. Guys, we can see Leon Bailey. Oh my God, what a ball, what a ball. Leon Bailey's done Martial there. Can we do the ball roll inside? Oh my God, we've done it. Please finesse that. Oh my God, what a goal that would have been. What a goal that would have been. Let's just take a look at that. Oh, it doesn't give us a really good angle there. But oh my God, we had Stegen beat at least. Oh no, no. Please not like this. No. Oh my God, what a save, Szczęsny. What a save. Nord Mukaleli's on the right-hand side of the pitch. We need Bailey to make a run. He has. He's listened. He's going to leave Roman Nogli for dead here. He's going to leave Roman Nogli for dead. We're going to see Timo Werner. Oh, my God. Can we make it 2-0? We have. Oh, my God. We've done it. We've done it. We've done it. We've done it. We made it 2-0 in the 30th minute. We made it, well, just before the 30th minute. Oh, my God. Werner is never missing that from there. And we hit them on the counter-attack superbly. That is the perfect counter-attack. All from a throw-in as well. Beautiful stuff. Guys, that is half-time. We are 2-0 up. I'll be honest with you, apart from those two goals, it's been nothing short of boring. Guys, Barca have been pressing me so high. Let's get back into the second half. Oh my God, what a ball, please. Oh no, no. What a goal that is. That's like the second shot they've had all game. Hey, Zeus, man, you can suck my left toe, you can. The question is, what happened to my defense here? There's a massive gap in the middle there, and no one was covering it. So, honestly, that was more the defense's fault than anything. But it is 2-1. We still have the lead, but it's 2-1 now. We get the ball to Leon Bailey. We've got so much space on this right-hand side of the field. What can we do with it? Can we do anything with it? Oh, my God. Oh, Werner, that pass needs to be better. But we get the return. Oh, my God, Ter Stegen, leave me alone. Oh, my God, what a save again. Ter Stegen, man, you gotta leave me alone, bro. Oh my God, please. Oh, leave me alone. We're getting really good chances now, guys. We're breaking Barca alone apart, piece by piece. Sabitzer, please. Oh my God. We've done it. We've done it. We have just done it. We have just done it. We have torn Barcelona apart. We are 3-1 up against Barcelona with 19 minutes left. It is literally our game to lose right now. Sabitzer, what a finish. Calm and composed as you like. We've been all over Barcelona in this second half period. Oh, what a goal that is. Can we hold on to this? Oh, no. What? Not again. Oh, what a save from Szczęsny. What a save. Money well spent. Yeah. Cry on the floor, Jesus. We've got Timo Werner. Timo Werner against Skriniar. Oh, my God. Guys. Can we find him? Please tell me he's got enough in the bank. Can we make this 4-1? Oh, my God. How do you miss from there? Oh, and Nkunku's left PK for dead. Can we finish this? Oh, my God. Leave me alone to stay again. Right, so you need goals. You need 2 goals, Barca, and you bring on Braithwaite. Oh, my God, Savitzer. Can we dink him? Oh, we've just done it in the most embarrassing fashion possible. Savitzer has got himself a brace, and we have dinked Ter Stegen, and we have fully destroyed Barcelona in the Champions League final. You absolutely love to see it. Let's take a look at this. Okay, so we get this ball to Sabitzer. No one's really pressing us. Ter Stegen came back way too early, and we just dink it over him like it was nothing. A perfect masterclass performance in the Champions League final against one of the greatest football teams in the world. And there we have it. We have beaten Barcelona 4-1 in the Champions League final. We have made RB Leipzig European champions at long last. Make sure you guys tell me in the comments down below who you want me to rebuild next. Don't think I'm ignoring you if your team as requested isn't getting done. I promise you at some point I will be doing them. It just takes a lot of time to do these videos. And as always, if you did go on to enjoy today's video, be sure to leave a like and smash that subscribe button. It really does help with the YouTube algorithm. The support on these videos has been nothing short of incredible. I am forever grateful for all of your support. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll see you later.